main news stories, or what are going to be the main news stories of the day, and starts assigning them from about 6:30 onwards to the various journalists and the reporters. As far as I'm concerned, I come in a little later. I go to the assigning officer and see what stories there are happening during the day, or I perhaps might come up with my own stories. If that's the case, I approach the cycleways at Campbelltown, obviously because that's... We decided to change our news format about 12 months ago, because instead of just presenting the basic facts in a very formal way with one newsreader, we decided on two newsreaders, male and female. A lot of people suggested that our new format was too chatty, which is something that quite amazes me, because it was never intended to be chatty at all. But again, you can go overboard. You could turn the whole show into a circus.
That's right, John. 8,000 children aged between 5 and 14 were hospitalised last year as a result of bicycle accidents. 22 were killed. So how do you solve the problem? Well, one city council southwest of Sydney think they may have the answer.
Campbelltown has the highest growth rate in the state, and 46% of the population comprises children under the age of 19. About 9,000 children own or ride bicycles. Earlier this year, the council distributed a questionnaire to both primary and high schools to find out the immediate needs of bicycle users. Town planner Dennis Smith told me council is very aware of the accidents involving bicycles, and it's their intention to build separate cycleways. So what did the survey reveal?
The survey revealed that if cycleway provisions were available, there would be a higher percentage of the children who were going to school would use them, providing we could assure them that they were safe and that they did give them quick and ready access to schools and shopping centres.
One area which is already extremely popular among children for bicycle riding is a housing commission estate in Minto. Although this was built as a pedestrian way, council hopes to convert it to a cycleway as part of their plan to build 26 kilometres of cycle paths. The concrete path links two schools, the housing commission, parks and a shopping centre. And according to the children who use it, it's much safer using the pathway than riding on the road.
Well, Richard, do you ride to school every day?
Not every day, sometimes. I just leave my bike at home because sometimes my parents don't like me riding to school.
Why do they think it's dangerous?
Because of some of the roads. Some people just tear along.
Have you had any accidents on your bike?
Oh, nearly, because I lost my brakes when I was going down the hill and a car just missed me.
Do you use this pathway a lot?
Yeah, I go over to the shops over there a lot for my parents.
Well, would you like to see more cycleways in the area?
Yes.
Do you think it would be safer?
Yeah.
The minister, for long, boring statements, said today, and in further consideration of what I've just said, I'd just like to put to the public at this point in time one question. Where was I?
It's not only them that puts the news together that's got to make choices. Us viewers have got a few too.
They help make it. Our news is better. 6 o'clock weeknights. This is Channel 10.